new book. So she's going to share some poetry with you this afternoon. So ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Miss Chelsea Marks.
How is everybody doing today?
Good.
My name is Chelsea Mock. Like Mr. Ben said, I grew up in Dream Studios. They just really good to me. They opened up a lot of doors for me, and this is where a lot of my training and everything came from, and I'm just blessed to be a part of this process and to grow a dream and to give back and to do this. So today I have three poems for you. This first one is called She's a Woman, and it's based off the women in my book. So it's just like a bunch of things that how they're feeling, what they're saying in the book. And the book's called Noun, and it'll be coming out in May. This has been an amazing journey, so I'm just gonna start. It's called She's a Woman. You see these eyes, lips, and thighs. Funny, that's the only thing you realize. But the way this soul and mind of mine works will leave you traumatized. You witness the way I break down and every time I cry, but when I shine, it'll make you go blind. Imagine being me, a woman. Wait, stop there, because you can't stand when I bleed. Baby, you can't have just one thing. You get me, you get everything. Home-cooked meals, clothes washed, dishes clean, bills in order, a house you can call a home. But yeah, I can't even get a weekend that doesn't involve your friend Jerome. You can't see this magic glowing all up in your face. And how every time I leave, my scent leaves a trace. Now, tell me, when did womanhood and manhood become a race? I mean, didn't God do y'all a favor when he made women? We're basically golden. Did I mention we bear children? We are teachers, doctors, lawyers, scholars, dentists, judges, creators, mentors, mothers, and yeah, your wives. And you think we have an attitude when we say we ain't got time for that. Yeah, ain't nobody got time for that couch loving, video game thugging. Wanna see Jim and Joe tonight at the log cabin? Let me get that late night loving. Why the bill's so high fussing? I need this and that cussing. You should be doing this instead of that coaching. And babe, be more like this crushing. Baby, I'm already perfect. Even God knows that because he made me a woman. Few pounds or extra pounds, my confidence too heavy. Maybe I need someone who could carry them because I'm comfortable.
All right.
And no matter what I do, it will be rememberable. So yes, baby, come home from work. Put your feet up after I've done everything. Let me get your dinner out and pour you a drink. And watch me look at you. Sip on this melanin. Swallow this upcoming degree. Rest on my hard work. Shower in the tub I just scrubbed. And sleep on the sheets that I just cleaned. So remember for the next time that you have a long day and feeling stressed, to ask your woman if it's her who needs to rest. She'll say no. Because being everything and doing everything is what she knows best. She's a woman. Thank you. So that first one is just based off the women in my book. There's three of them, and they go through different things. And I know noun seems strange, but for some reason that word, it travels, it sees things, it means person, place, or thing. And I just feel like, you know, anyone who's into things like that would read, you know, look under the text and really agree and, you know, try to connect with the words. This next one is called My Woman, and it's something that I wrote. I pulled up out of my archives that I've been working on. You know, it takes me a while to write anything. I've been working on this one for about a year, funny. It's called My Woman, and it's based on me. Sometimes I fathom my thoughts as to why something potentially beautiful is so ugly. And why loving you makes me hate myself. No, I'm not trying to win your heart or wake up one day and you be everything I need. Just thought I'd let you know there are some things you taught me. This isn't a diss, and I'm not trying to reminisce, but by all means, I wish I was something you could miss. I hope you're all right and never had to cry all night, and thank you for coming into my life and showing me this way and then leaving before I even had words to say. But if you don't mind, there are some things I would like to tell you. First, I am okay. In fact, I've learned to walk, talk, survive, and did it all without calling you dad. Imagine being 5 and another man tell you not to be sad. Maybe you were too busy, or when I was a baby, I was a bit too fussy, but still, I managed. Isn't that crazy? So I learned you loved the streets, and I had to redirect my energy. No, I didn't reach a college degree. Now we have one thing in common. I guess books and all personalities don't agree. It's 2018, and so far, looking through my timeline of photos, your picture is yet to be seen. But let's pause here. That didn't stop me. I learned to cook clean and allowed another man to love me. Now I'm 21, engaged with an apartment, and this man takes care of me. And somehow knowing he will be a better father sets my heart free. There's more to saying you have a daughter than she has my lips, same eyes, and same laughter. No love lost, just telling you all this made me tough. And soon our paths will cross. And my woman will be the bravest, toughest, and strongest man that you ever met. Thank you, sorry.